The sky has always held a sort of primordial fascination for mankind. Every sunset has its beauty. Every night brings forth its celestial wonders. For a certain somewhat rare bird, the amateur astronomer, this fascination can become intense.
It is addictive.
Just the sheer beauty, the aesthetics of things you see in the sky. Some of the globular clusters, for instance, are pretty fascinating just to look at in the eyepiece.
Here at Butter Pot Provincial Park, 40 clicks outside of St. John's, amateur astronomers from the local Royal Astronomical Society of Canada chapter are busy setting up some high-tech gear.
Laptop, controllers, video.
Every August for the last 10 years, this group has staged its big weekend star party.
Cool.
The public is invited, and this year lots of folks drop by for a look way out.
Just to be able to see something like that's like not on Earth, it's just so far away, but it's just really different.
You can cruise along the Milky Way in the summer if you're under dark skies, and as you get down towards the thicker part of the Milky Way, you just see clusters and nebulae. There's the Swan Nebula and the Triffid Nebula and the Eagle Nebula and all of these things. They pop out pretty nicely in big aperture.
Aperture is a hot-button word for astronomers. It refers to the diameter of the light-gathering mirror or lens of a telescope.
Here the mirror is 18 inches across. It collects a lot of starlight and galaxy light and things, and it shows very nice bright images.
Seeing the Veil Nebula, I mean, that was awesome. You couldn't stop looking at it. Each of us lined up just wanting to look through the big scope.
Chris's scope cost him about $2,500 to build. Then there are the eyepieces. Most astronomers have several to enable different magnification powers and wider or narrower fields of view.
So you can see here the clear difference in these eyepieces.
At a star party, astronomy software is extremely useful.
That's the typical moon itself when it's full.
It seems like a bit of an expensive hobby, but the price of entry-level computerized telescopes has come way down.
To get a small telescope with GoTo Now, you can get for under $200. Get you started.
A computerized scope not only points itself, it also describes the target.
I can tell you that in this case it's 8,000 light years away.
1 light year equals 10 trillion kilometers. Through a telescope, you're not just seeing far, you're also seeing huge and very old.
When you're looking at a galaxy 10 or 15 or 20 million light years away, so the light you're seeing is that old. So you're literally looking back in time 20 million years at something that's the size of the entire galaxy that you live in.
Closer to home, sunlight takes about 8 minutes to reach the Earth. A specially filtered solar telescope shows prominences and flares on the sun.
This is a picture taken with that telescope.
Awesome! The flares! Huh? The solar flares!
Ooh, yeah, I've heard that the Earth can easily fit through one of those solar flares with miles of spare space.
Astronomers were handing out star finders, magazines, and educational stuff at the party. Maybe it was the cosmic t-shirt, maybe it was the clear night that put them in the mood for their favorite song, Across the Universe.
Like a million suns, it calls me on and on, across the universe.
For NTV News, I'm Steve Thompson at the Butterpot Star Party.